Well, in Dublin City in 1913, the boss was rich and the poor were slaves. The women working, the children starving. Then on came Larkin like a mighty wave. The workers cringed when the boss man pondered that 70 hours was to be his weekly chore. Though he asked for little, when less was granted, less getting smaller and he'd ask for more. In the month of August, the boss man told us no union man for him could work. But we stood by Larkin and we told the boss man we'd fight or die, but we would not shirk. For months we fought and for months we starved, and we stood by Larkin through thick and thin. But foodless homes and the crying of children, it broke our hearts, we just couldn't win. Then Larkin left us, we seemed defeated. The night went black for the working man. Then on came Connolly with new hope and counsel. His motto was that we'd rise again. In 1916 in Dublin City, the English soldiers, they burnt our town. They shelled our buildings and shot our leaders. The hat was buried beneath the fucking crown. They shot McDermott and Pearson Plunkett. They shot McDonough and Clark the Brave. From Bleak Kilmainham they took their bodies to Arbor Hill and a quicklime grave. But last of all of the seven heroes, I'll sing the praise of James Connolly. The voice of justice, the voice of freedom, he gave his life so we might be free. Well, in Belfast City, in the late 70s, the prods were better, Catholics dirt poor. Then came Bobby Sands with a revelation, passive resistance could be the cure. For months he starved, and then when he died, the British did not heed the kids. In ghettos crying, our faded pictures still ring the gutters with their dustbin lids. The economy's battered and more towards equal, more pleasant times they are creeping in. Just yearly problems, annual agitation are now among the worst of our sins. But still in all we can scarce remember how to forget here what we have seen. We'll long time know it, but when we're all gone, no one will march in memory of what's been.